Hello everyone and welcome back to Veluwe Zoo. And in the previous episode we started on the African section and we built a wonderful habitat for the elephants. But we didn't finish the building, so we have to do that this episode of course. But first we have to do some important stuff as well. We have to manage our zoo and I got a message. Feeding station cannot be reached. Well, it is filled. So that's kind of weird. And another one. So this has worked all the time. But now it doesn't. Call keeper and we'll see what happens. I also got some gifts. So adopt and place 6 different habitat species. I'm gonna claim that reward. Thank you very much. And yeah, I think it's time to do something about this. So 3 burgers outside didn't work. We only had 1 party over here. But now it's time to get bigger and better. I'm gonna show them. They will get the burger they want. The biggest burger in the world. There you go. Now we'll wait and see how many people will come to this burger. You see that guy over there? He looks hungry. He looks hungry. Oh. Apparently not. We have some dangerous fighting pronghorn antelope. I think we have a bit too many of them. Oh, and we also finished some research on the bison, on the doll sheep, and on the Siberian tiger as well. Mr. Eric Crossland has nothing to do, so we have to make sure he's researching something at least. But it looks like we already finished everything. Oh well, he can have a break for now. So we're gonna take a look at the animals, and we have to take a look at the pronghorn antelope. There you go, so we have way too many males, and I might gonna send you to the trade center. And we have quite a few animals in the trade center, so I have to sell these as well. So maybe if you're lucky and you are in the trade center right now, you will get some Veluwe Zoo pronghorn antelope. I mean, what else do you want in your life? Let's take a look at all the animals. So we have quite a few peafowls going on over here. You can see that we have around 300 peafowls in here. They are everywhere. So let's see if we can sell a few. Peafowl, let's see. Indian peafowl maybe. Indian peafowl, there you go. See, oh, that's quite a list. That's quite a list. So I'm gonna send them all to the trade center. There's so many of them. You see, it's incredible. Okay, let's send them to the trade center. There you go. How are my llamas doing? Also, a lot of llamas. 7 llamas and 1 habitat, and then we don't even count the babies. It's incredible. We have a few hundred flamingos as well. Everything is going really, really well. And of course, we still have a giant burger over there. How are these crocodiles doing? They're only 4. Ah, that's okay. Gharials, only 3 of them, but all female. I think that's a good thing because they were reproducing like rabbits. So we finished some more research on the Siberian tiger. And I think that will be it for the managing. All the zoo is running fine as usual. And we have a lot to do in this episode. So let's switch to the time lapse right now. And welcome to the time lapse. As mentioned before, today is going to be a big one. So we're going to finish up the entire elephant area. And we're also adding a complete new staff area on the side as well. So as you can already see, the video is quite long, a bit longer than usual, but I think it's definitely worth it. But first of all, if you made it to this far in the video and you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, make sure you do. There is a lot more Veluwe Zoo upcoming soon, so you won't miss out on anything, of course. But yeah, we start off with this beautiful elephant house. And first of all, I want to thank everyone because the first video about the elephants just hit 20k views, and it's the best viewed video on the channel. It's incredible. So I thought, okay, these elephants really need a decent indoor area as well. So I decided to basically completely remove the building I already had and make it 10 times bigger than it was. So what I'm doing right now, while I was building this, I thought, okay, this looks too similar as the aardvark habitat I already did. with the stones on the side, and I wanted to do something more with the wood structure and also a little bit more modern looking. So it looks like this part of the zoo is added later on, and it's really cool to combine the African section or the African theme together with like a temperate region and then also with some modern structures as well. It's gonna be difficult, but it's another take on the African theme if you ask me. So the indoor area of course will be like a savanna. Of course I can't really do the terrain work, so I will basically make everything look like sand, and then I will work with the desert rocks and the savanna rocks or the grassland rocks, I'm not sure what they're called. But the outside of the building is going to be a little bit different, as you can see. So I'm using these logs and a lot of wood, and I have to admit the piece count is incredible in the end. I think I'm probably not able to upload it to the Steam Workshop. I think I hit the 4K blueprint limit pretty much halfway, I think. So yeah, a lot of rocks and a lot of sand as usual. Of course, I tried to cut out quite a lot, because you can see I will do the same thing over and over. Of course I will add these electrical stuff and the water treatments, because you have to remember Veluwe Zoo is just a franchise zoo. I know making strange stuff in this zoo and it looks like a sandbox one, but we have to keep in mind the managing as well. So we have to, I don't have a button to just say, okay, power everything and that's it. So we have to keep in mind, we have to add power and the water treatments as well. And this area is really big, so I'm going to add another one on the backstage area on the other side of the building. So what I'm doing right now is I'm creating the entrance on the side. And as you can see, you will enter the building and you will have the feeling that you're actually entering like a desert or a grassland area. Basically the same thing as you have in the desert house, but this time I wanted to do it for some bigger animals. So there's going to be elephants on this side, and as you can see I already started a little bit on the other side as well of the building, and that's going to be the next episode. I will finish up finish up the indoor area for them, but in the next episode we are going to create a African safari on the other side with like 8 different animals in it. They will be able to enter this building, and of course they will have a huge outdoor area. I'm thinking about adding a transport ride over there as well. I'm not sure yet if it's going to be something like a train or a jeep. Let me know down in the comments what you would like to see, and I'm going to try to add it to the park as well. So a lot of finishing up in the building. You can probably imagine that like using these logs and this structure it's kind of a struggle. I cut out a lot and still the video is quite long. That's also because I got a little bit carried away with the staff area on the back, because I was building that actually live on Twitch. If you have missed that, make sure you also follow me on Twitch. There is a link down in the description. It was actually quite a random live stream. I just wanted to check out Twitch and see how it works. And I just wanted to finish up this build, and we ended up streaming for like three and a half hours, making like a complete backdoor area with like all the staff buildings. It looked really cool. But yeah, if you want to check that one out as well, I think there is a replay function on Twitch. I'm not sure. But anyway, I will do some more live streams. I've actually like been live streaming this week for 3 times already, I think 2 or 3 times. I'm not sure yet where I will continue the career mode. I think I'm gonna stick that to YouTube, and then of course all the community stuff like a Veluwe or a 5k stream, stuff like that will all be on YouTube. But like building streams on Veluwe Zoo, just to have a sneak peek, I'm gonna do that on Twitch, I think. My plans are changing every week, so I'm not sure yet. We'll see what feels best and what feels right and what people actually like to see. So right now I already added quite a few fences, some safety barriers for the elephants, and actually they can't enter the water in the game, but right now some realism in real life they would be able to enter it, and I don't want them to eat some gas, although they probably won't eat them. But anyway, I'm covering up the sides with rocks just to make it look a little bit more natural and also for some safety. And I think probably the elephants will destroy anything they can touch. So yeah, I'm gonna cover everything up with the rocks on the inside again. Not as many as in the desert building, just a few rocks to cover up the sides, and that's it. So I'm already putting in some roofing. I know it's you shouldn't do that, but someone on the stream just mentioned you can use Q and E to move your camera up and down. I know I have 600 hours in the game. I made almost, 75 videos. I really have no clue. And I just figured it out. You can use Q and E to enter the building while you already have a roof on it. But as you can see, the roof was a little bit too low and I had to fix that. I basically have to fix the entire building, but I cut that out. I'm just showing you right now that I have to raise everything. I have to raise all these little bars and all the pillars and stuff like that. But yeah, I cut that out. And the palm tree was also still a little bit too high. I actually removed it because the transversible area for the elephants indoors was a little bit too small. I think it's something they need to fix for the elephants. The transversible area is a little bit weird. When you place down one rock, they can't use, a square kilometer around it. But maybe they will fix that, of course, in a new update. And as you've probably seen, there is a new update coming with like different animal colors. Really exciting to see. They are still working on something. And of course, everyone is expecting a new DLC soon. Yeah, I'm not sure what it's going to be and when it's going to come out. Hopefully very soon. Let me know down in the comments what you would like to see in the next DLC. I mean, probably a lot of people would like some aquatic animals or some birds, but I'm not sure if that's going to happen. If you ask me, it's probably going to be something like an Australian DLC or something like that. That would be perfect. I can already imagine adding a Australian part to a Velua Zoo as well. Or maybe, yeah, I'm thinking about doing something different when a DLC comes out. But it really depends on what kind of DLC will come. But yeah, of course, you will see that on the channel when time is there. There's a lot of work going on the building today, and as you can see, the other side, I'm basically doing the same stuff. So a lot of sand and creating these paths. Something I would like to see in the game as well are some null paths. So basically a path without these wooden things around it, so people can just walk around. And I'm using the same fence all over the place. Of course, the same rock work on the side. I'm combining the savannah rocks or grassland rocks together with the desert rocks just to make some nice difference in textures and in colors. And that's basically it for probably this building. I mean, the inside is more or less the same on this side. I only put down two trees on this side because I really want to do that in the next episode. First thing, I have to check out if the giraffes will be able to enter the building. I'm not sure yet. So I'm not sure if I'm gonna combine them or maybe make some little shelter for them separately, or little shelter is gonna be a big one, otherwise they won't be able to enter it as well. But yeah, we will have to see. So a lot of like elephant grass, of course, some nice trees just to make it look a little bit more finished. I actually can use these plants. I didn't know that, so I wanted to use them. Again, a franchise zoo, you will have to keep in mind benches, bins and donation boxes, education stands. Of course, I'm throwing everything in there, and although it's not looking really nice, I still have to do it. Some nice African themed props, of course, and I'm just playing around with all the props. There is a lot in the game for this African section. So yeah, I'm kind of, why didn't I start this before? Why didn't I start any African projects or something like that? Because we can really use a lot of this. And it's actually, it's a cool theme. And yeah, I'm enjoying it. So this is where the stream has started. So we started on doing a little backdoor area. I had some reference images that I used for this. So what we're gonna do is we add a... we had a staff building, so the bigger ones. We add the big staff building, the big keeper hut. We add a vet place, we add power, we basically add everything. And there's a little jump in time because I already created the building. I didn't like it. So I completely ripped it down or ripped it apart, and we are back to basically zero because I didn't like the roof structure that I made and the building was a little bit too small. So I'm creating the roof again, and in the end I'm really happy with how this turned out. It really looks realistic in one way, and really clean and really neat and completely different from the normal building, of course. And I think in zoos they really don't care about like how the backstage areas are looking. It's just practical, and so we have a wall, we put the buildings in there, and we have a roof, and that's it. But I'm just trying to add small details like the drains and the gutters. I never work with those. So yeah, if you were there in the stream, you know that I didn't even know the name for these pieces. And every time I'm playing, I literally just find new pieces that I can use. So these will be the colors that I use all over this place. So basically the black roof together with the nice details of the wood in the building. And then you can see I'm throwing down all the staff buildings as well. And the path, of course, that was a struggle. Trying to connect it here, it doesn't work. And yeah, it's a struggle. It's horrible, I know. Just yeah, what I did in the end, I just got the grid from the building itself, and I placed down all the paths. You can see I'm deleting the entire thing and placing down the new path right here. In the end, the building was a little bit too big, so I had to move it to the pathing again. So you can imagine it was a fun stream, and actually it worked out pretty well. I was not sure about this. I mean, streaming and recording at the same time and then trying to make a time lapse out of it. I was expecting to be, the editing to be kind of a struggle. But it worked out pretty well. You can actually see when I was talking to the chat, and that's it. And then I tried to cut that out because, yeah, there was nothing happening over there, of course. But I think in the end, we did quite a good job on that. And the image is quite smooth and the video is quite smooth. You might see something in the end like, okay, you can see that it's a live stream, but... yeah, I don't know. It was fun. I really enjoying the live streams and connecting with the community a little bit more. We've been playing some Fall Guys as well together with some people on the Discord. If you're not on the Discord channel yet, make sure you join that one as well. There is a link down in the description. A lot of great people over there would just love the game and love the community. So that's a good thing. So yeah, just some doors, some windows, and then we will start with the gutters and stuff. So yeah, basically we just added some small details to the staff area. We will finish up the building, and that is probably it. So as you might know, it's around 38 degrees right now in the Netherlands, and yeah, it's just really warm in here. So I'm gonna leave you guys with the rest of the video, and I really hope you enjoyed this one. And if you did, make sure you hit the like button. And if you didn't do it already, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you won't miss out on any new content. And also, if you want to support the channel, become a member. That's the best way to support me. And as you might know, I basically invest anything I earn with this channel back into the channel and trying to improve the quality of the content and the quantity as well. So yeah, I really hope to see you guys in the next one. Goodbye!